Good morning, everyone. It is Monday, and we are on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange with Jim Cramer to talk about the markets. Jim, let's start off with stocks at new record highs, 2507 in the S&P 500.
Yeah, there's a lot of groups that are doing well that are unexpected. Autos are doing well. Housing's doing well. Airlines struggling, but truckers doing better. I'm seeing some tremendous numbers out of the rails. Look at KSU. That's the car railroad up from Mexico. We also have, I think, nascent base building in the oils, which is pretty amazing. And then we had biotech move a lot. And we had the big drug companies move a lot. And those are weak dollar plays. So there's a lot of forces coalescing on light volume. And in the interim, we do not have any real big data this week. But remember, we're in a sweet spot in that we that 19% of the market actually that is doing nothing in financials wants very much for rates to go higher. So when you're in a situation where people are talking about a temper tantrum or a tape transom, whatever, all I can tell you is the Fed's irrelevant right now. Because if the Fed does something to tighten, the market goes higher. And if it does nothing, the market could go higher. Unless there's an exogenous event, and obviously an exogenous event is one we can't necessarily think about, South Korea, North Korea, but it's interesting because I think that the Orbital deal is very North Korea, South Korea oriented. That's that acquisition by Northrop Grumman.
Yeah, what is your view of defense stocks right now?
I've liked them all, and I've liked them for a long time. I like Lockheed Martin. I like Raytheon very much. General Dynamics, not as much. Bob Lang is like that for Trifecta. He did a piece for us on our off-the-charts segment. Here's the thing that people have to recognize about defense stocks. There's not a lot of them. That's why people like Kratos, there's just not a lot of defense companies because they've merged. And now with that Trump being the salesperson in chief for us when it comes to weapons, and when you look at Boeing being a great company, this group remains hot, and I don't think it's going away.
And Jim, we know September is typically the worst month of the year for the stock market. There's an article in Real Money about how this week is actually the worst week of the year for the market.
Well, I think that's important. And I think that what's happened is that it's interesting. This is a Jewish holiday week, and there's been some time, a lot of volatility there, in part because there's not as many players. Someone wants to hit the market down, they can do it. I point out that General Mills, FedEx, not much else this week. So it would have to be on something from outside the realm because there's just not a lot of information that things are trading on.
All right, Jim, let's talk about Nvidia. The stock is up over 5% since your AAP call last week. What incredible call.
Well, thank you.
Bravo.
We tried to get everyone in the club. It was the stock that we pushed the hardest in the club call. We do the club call, and people have to recognize that in the club call, we try to do our favorite stock. We try to flesh out why we just bought something. We give you our overview, and we answer your questions, which because we're very interactive. And we kept coming back to Nvidia being an undervalued stock in relation to what people don't understand it. They think it's a crypto mining play. Well, it's got some crypto mining. It was mentioned on the conference call. It's really artificial intelligence, machine learning, it's voice, which is so important. It's autonomous driving. Its data center business is fantastic. And when you have all of those trends coalescing, you can see why a stock would go higher.
Well, and it has quite a price target raised by Bank of America this
morning. Yeah, they did it again, and that piece is a good piece. I mean, I think that what people have to recognize is that the stock was stalled because of a data center transition chip and because of a belief that China's going to shut down Bitcoin. And, when you have a stock that's as hot as Nvidia, it really shouldn't be able to take, it should go down on these things. But what it did was just stall. And what just stalled because the product transition on the data center is going to be solved. And because the Chinese did not ban crypto mining, they just banned Bitcoin. So I just don't want the stock to be associated with cryptocurrency. I think there's so much more to it.
What did you make of Caterpillar's upgrade at UBS?
Well, the Caterpillar upgrade is a lot of it has to do with Streamline. A lot of it has to do with a $14 number. I've always thought that if we ever get to $10, it would be a big deal. A lot of it is because a lot of people are short Caterpillar. There's an underlying base of certain companies that have been shorted and shorted aggressively. The E&P companies, the disk drive companies, Caterpillar. These were plays. Caterpillar made a number of mistakes in China. a belief that when you see copper going down, copper's at a kind of a critical level, that you should go against Caterpillar. But what people don't realize is the demand for pipelines in this country and the demand from the rebuilds for Florida and Texas are going to be gigantic for Caterpillar.
Are people underestimating these rebuilds in Florida and Texas?
I think they are, because these are not waiting for federal. Look, Katrina was a very underinsured area that needed federal help. Both Florida and Texas were fully insured areas where a lot of people are going to be able to get fully insured for auto in Texas and fully insured for wind because Florida's got such standards. I just think that what people don't recognize is that, as I've been saying, the check's in the mail. There's going to be money toward these areas. So if you look at like a CarMax, which reports, so you look at a GM, that breakout in GM, I don't think people realize how hard it is to have a breakout in a stock that has really lagged. That is not about China and electric cars. That is really about the demand for cars and trucks.
All right, Jim, let's move on to Facebook. Congress is concerned about Russia propaganda ads ahead of last year's election. How are you watching this?
Well, I mean, I think, look, this is a newsy story, but the takeaway is incorrect. The takeaway should be this, that Facebook has so much advertising that it was like difficult to kind of ferret out that the Russians were even doing this. And it's just they've got such a quantity of page views that it's not like they can control their channels. The repercussions might be like Procter, where Procter pulled back from some advertising. But I think that what will really end up happening is that Facebook will cooperate, they'll give them the information, and advertising will continue.
All right, meanwhile, Hewlett-Packard Enterprise actually has four activist investors as shareholders, according to a Bernstein note.
Yeah, you know, you got to have numbers. I don't see the numbers there. I don't know how they bring out more value. I think they're certainly trying. But like Cisco, they're caught up in a big move from on-premise to off-premise to the cloud. And there's a lot of companies duking it out for the on-premise and not that many for the cloud. And Oracle did not have a blowout quarter for the cloud. I think you play cloud as Salesforce, Salesforce, Salesforce.
Yes, you said that before. All right, Jim, let's end with earnings to watch. We have three I want to talk about. We talked a little bit about the storms earlier. What are you expecting from AutoZone's quarter?
I think AutoZone is a place you go to buy a car. And that means that Houston's going to give it a lot of business.
All right, how about FedEx?
I think FedEx has a cyber hack that is going to drive the numbers down, and you wait till that's reported, and then you buy.
Adobe.
Adobe is just a red hot stock, and you know it's all the way up to 155. We sold it. We had a 30% gain for Action Alert. I thought we were being greedy. That was wrong. Stock maybe goes down 5-6 on a mediocre number. You buy it.
All right, Jim Cramer, we'll leave it there. Thank you so much. As always, for more information on the stocks Jim mentioned, please head back to thestreet.com.